key to a long and lasting love? Well, Jeffrey and his Milda McKenzie will share with us now. Good morning, you lovely lovebirds.
Thank you.
Good morning, Garth.
Thank you, good morning.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, ma'am. Great to meet you both. This is what, July 27?
Yes.
And we are what, 24 now?
Yes.
So in 3 days, 50
three
years?
3 days, time.
3 days?
We celebrate 50 years.
Fantastic. How did you meet this gentleman, ma'am?
It's a long story. It will take the whole morning.
In a nutshell, tell me just...
I was at the United Theological College boarding because I was a student at the university. And we went into college very early on the second semester. And he and his friends were on the corridor talking. So my sister and I, we walked down the corridor and we stopped and we chatted. And then he invited me to a cricket match at Sabina Park because he heard me talking about cricket, because my brothers usually listen to the Shell Shield. So the Friday before we went to the match, about 12 o'clock, something hit me. Wow, I'm going out with the best man at the United Theological College. Believe it or not, and I couldn't hold myself together. I said to my sister, say, you know something, going out with the best man, Jeff? And she said, go and enjoy yourself. And that was it. And not to mention that when we reached the cricket match, I never see one ball bowl. I was just eyeing him on the side. What a handsome man. Look at his nose and all these things, believe it or not. And I was just whoop, all over.
You remember smitten. Who was playing the match?
No, sir. Jamaica and me, none who else.
It was Guyana.
Jamaica and Guyana. Jeffrey, did you know or did you foresee that you would have, one, married Esmilda, and two, be married for so long?
Well, to say it openly, I loved her when I met her 50 years ago. Just for a couple of minutes, we shared on the corridor. And having invited her to go to the cricket match, I discovered that she had some crush on me.
Couldn't hide. Couldn't hide at all.
So Mrs. McKenzie never said, you know, me like this man in my camera go cricket match. You know, if you go dinner and lunch and all kind of thing. You never say anything like that in your mind.
No. It's time. It takes time to know him.
Yeah, so the cricket match.
You get that amount of time.
You sit down the whole day and know him and watch cricket.
For couples who are wondering, you know, what it takes to sustain a marriage, you know, with a family, right, for 50 years, what are the top two things you'd say, the two most important things to keeping it together?
The family that prays together.
Stays
together. And that is what we have been practicing in our own personal lives, with the two of us and with the whole family.
Yeah.
We pray together, we bring everything to Almighty God, and we communicate.
Yeah.
When that is done.
You quarrel?
Huh?
You quarrel?
We quarrel, honey?
Sometimes we have
hard talk, but not to quarrel.
Yeah.
No.
A little disagreement here and there.
We have our differences.
Yes.
But we ensure that we make up and we settle our differences. Even before we go to bed.
But hold on, no mums, man. So there was never a time that you vexed with him for all day and, you know.
No, me vex for the day, you know.
Yeah.
But me going to my bed. You don't know what can happen in the bed, so we just have
to fix it up.
Okay, it's a morning program. Careful. Careful. Why make them not clear for you?
Ah. So we have to just...
So absolutely no regrets here.
Regrets? None. None whatsoever. I think I've gotten the best man in the whole wide world. He was created just for me.
Oh, okay, then.
That's beautiful, eh?
Daddy?
I'm passionate.
Daddy, when you're hearing these nice things, what you thinking about now?
She was divinely sent.
Ah, beautiful.
God brought us together. Because I had a failed relationship. And then I met her. And in 7 months, we discover that we were in love with each other. And we made the vow to commit ourselves to each other. And it has lasted for 50 years.
Daddy, how did you propose? You go down on your knee and all kind of thing? Mm-hmm. How did you propose?
Yes, I did. Bow my knees and ask her, would you marry me? And she said yes without any hesitation.
You never know if I said she could have said no.
No, I was confident that she had something strong going.
Yes. Beautiful. Beautiful.
Wow, 7 months proposal and 50 years thereafter.
I tell you, it is God's divine plan for both of us.
Absolutely.
When is your birthday?
Last week? December 4.
Oh, yeah, his birthday.
And when is your birthday?
18th of July.
So you just have a birthday
last week.
Last week.
I'm giving a shout out on the show last week.
Yes, I remember. I actually do remember. I do remember now.
Yes.
This is fantastic. Yes. I'll cry when I want to cry, you know, but anything.
No, don't cry. Don't cry. But I'm telling you, marriage is a holy estate. Marriage is just precious. And I would just invite everyone to be a part of this great institution because of what this man has carried into the relationship. Awesome.
Congrats again. Fantastic to meet you both. God bless you both.
Thank you so much.
Come back in another 50 years and sit down and talk.
No, man. You know, at the time, they'll be wool and bone white.
God bless you both.
Thank you.
And the rest of your family.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you for having us.
You're an inspiration.
Thank you for having us. And to continue with our celebration, I wish to offer to you this anniversary. Yes.
The Mackenzie Happy 50th.
Yes.
Ooh,
nice.
I'll get them for you. Yeah, man.
This is lovely.
How many of them are there?
Oh, we have a whole team of about 15.
No, don't worry, because them can't write, mommy.
Yeah.
You know, make sure I'll get them.
All right.
Yeah,
all right, thank you so much for coming. And again, God bless you.
Thank you so much. Married for 50 years.
Well, on July 27, it will be 50 years.
Yes.
Married Jeffrey and Esmilda.
And our theme will be resounding praise for 50 years.
Resounding praise.
God bless you both. Yes. Soon come. Stay with us.